MIT researchers have developed a way to produce holograms almost instantly. They say the deep learning based method is so efficient that it could run on your smartphone. The new method called the Tensor Holography could enable the creation of holograms for virtual reality, 3D printing, medical imaging and more. Despite years of hype, virtual reality headsets have yet to topple TV or computer screens as the go-to devices for video viewing. One reason, VR can make users feel sick. Nausea and eye strain can result because VR creates an illusion of 3D viewing, although the user is in fact staring at a fixed distance 2D display. The solution for better 3D visualization could lie in a 60-year-old technology remade for the digital world, holograms. Holograms deliver an exceptional representation of 3D world around us, plus they are beautiful. Holograms offer a shifting perspective based on the viewer's position, and they allow the eye to adjust focal depth to alternately focus on foreground and background. Researchers have long sought to make computer-generated holograms, but the process has traditionally required a supercomputer to churn through physics simulations, which is time-consuming and can yield less than photorealistic results. Now, MIT researchers have developed a new way to produce holograms almost instantly, and the deep learning-based method is so efficient that it can run on a laptop in the blink of an eye. People previously thought that with the existing consumer-grade hardware, it was impossible to do real-time 3D holographic computations. It's often been said that commercially available holographic displays will be around in 10 years, yet this statement has been around for decades. The new approach, which the team calls Tensor Holography, will finally bring that elusive 10-year goal within reach. The advance could fuel a spillover of holography into fields like VR and 3D printing. This research paper is published in the journal Nature. A typical lens-based photograph encodes the brightness of each light wave. A photo can faithfully reproduce a scene's colors, but it ultimately yields a flat image. In contrast, a hologram encodes both the brightness and phase of each light wave. That combination delivers a truer depiction of a scene's parallax and depth. So, while a photograph of Monet's water lilies can highlight the painting's color palette, a hologram can bring the work to life, rendering the unique 3D texture of each brushstroke. But despite their realism, holograms are a challenge to make and share. First developed in the mid-1900s, early holograms were recorded optically. That record splitting a laser beam, with half the beam used to illuminate the subject and the other half used as a reference for the light wave space. This reference generates a hologram's unique sense of depth. The resulting images were static, so they couldn't capture motion, and they were hard copy only, making them difficult to reproduce and share. Computer-generated holography sidesteps these challenges by simulating the optical setup, but the process can be a computational slog. Because each point in the scene has a different depth, we can't apply the same operations for all of them. That increases the complexity significantly. Directing a clustered supercomputer to run these physics-based simulations could take seconds or minutes for a single holographic image. Plus, existing algorithms don't model occlusion with photorealistic precision. So, the MIT team took a different approach, letting the computer teach physics to itself. They used deep learning to accelerate computer-generated holography, allowing for real-time hologram generation. The team designed a convolutional neural network, a processing technique that uses a chain of trainable tensors to roughly mimic how humans process visual information. Training a neural network typically requires a large, high-quality dataset which didn't previously exist for 3D holograms. The team built a custom database of 4,000 pairs of computer-generated images. Each pair matched a picture including color and depth information for each pixel with its corresponding hologram. To create the holograms in the new database, the researchers used scenes with complex and variable shapes and colors, with the depth of pixels distributed evenly from the background to the foreground, and with a new set of physics-based calculations to handle occlusion. That approach resulted in photorealistic training data. Next, the algorithm got to work. By learning from each image pair, the tensor network tweaked the parameters of its own calculations, successfully enhancing its ability to create holograms. The fully optimized network operated orders of magnitude faster than physics-based calculations. That efficiency surprised the team themselves. The researchers are amazed at how well it performs. In mere milliseconds, Tensor Holography can craft holograms from images with depth information, which is provided by typical computer-generated images and can be calculated from a multi-camera setup or LiDAR sensor. This advance paves the way for real-time 3D holography. What's more, the compact tensor network requires less than 1 MB of memory. It is negligible considering the tens and hundreds of gigabytes available on the latest cell phone. The research shows that true 3D holographic displays are practical with only moderate computational requirements. This paper shows marked improvement in image quality over previous work, which will add realism and comfort for the viewer. Holographic displays like this could even be customized to a viewer's ophthalmic prescription. Holographic displays can correct for aberrations in the eye. This makes it possible for a display image sharper than what the user could see with contacts or glasses, which only correct for low-order aberrations like focus and astigmatism. Real-time 3D holography would enhance a slew of systems, from VR to 3D printing. The team says the new system could help immerse VR viewers in more realistic scenery while eliminating eye strain and other side effects of long-term VR use. The technology could be easily deployed on displays that modulate the phase of light waves. Currently, most affordable consumer-grade displays modulate only brightness, though the cost of phase modulating displays would fall if widely adopted. Three-dimensional holography could also boost the development of volumetric 3D printing. This technology could prove faster and more precise than traditional layer-by-layer 3D printing, since volumetric 3D printing allows for the simultaneous projection of the entire 3D pattern. Other applications include microscopy, visualization of medical data, and the design of surfaces with unique optical properties. It is a considerable leap that could completely change people's attitudes toward holography.